We do have a graphic of some of the highlights, or some of the things, let's say, that stem cells can do. So let's look at these and walk me through them, doctor. Let's see the first one. If we could take that, Ed, thank you. Against Ed on standby, always ready for me. What can stem cells do? Support repair of damaged tissue, which you touched upon, doctor?
Correct. Right. So if you have a tear in a soft tissue, ordinarily your body would form some scar tissue. It may not form very good scar tissue. Something like PRP or stem cell may aid it in forming the proper tissue. Plus, it may do that faster.
Okay, reduce inflammation at times?
Correct. There's a lot of interleukins. These are just types of proteins and biochemistry, like how you get a fever.
Uh-huh.
There are things that get released to cause a fever.
Okay.
Same thing, there are cells that cause inflammation in your knee, and PRP and stem cells have been known to reduce that.
May promote soft tissue reconstruction.
Correct. These are not necessarily the worker bees. These are more the managers, the on-site contractors. And so what we hope is that they come and they bring with them the power to secrete all these growth factors to promote the repair.
Slow healing process?
It actually speeds up the healing process.
Okay.
For almost everything. There are some studies that actually show that stem cells can improve fracture healing in bone, healing of soft tissue like hamstrings in those injuries. And then if you have a bad case of tennis elbow, stem cells or PRP are a very good source of treatment.